Hello everyone, welcome to another Godot tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to implement this sign in with Google button using Firebase. Do note that the method I'm going to show you will only work on desktop and web builds. Technically, you can implement the sign in with Google on Android too, and someone has already shared their steps on GitHub. But it's much more complicated and I won't cover that in this video. With that out of the way, let's talk about prerequisites. Before starting, you should have already created the Firebase project, installed the Godot Firebase plugin, and have the basic authentication implemented. If not, please take a look at my previous tutorial. The first half of it will show you how to do so. Alright, let's get started. First of all, in the Firebase console, go to Authentication, then Sign In Methods, click on Add New Provider, and select Google. Enable it and click Save. Now, go to the Google Cloud console. If this is your first time here, you'll need to select your project from the top right. Now, click on API and Services. On the left panel, go to OAuth Consent Screen. If you already have this set up, you can skip to the next step. If you're just testing, you can choose Internal. But to let people outside of your organization to use the Sign In with Google feature, you need to choose External. If you are publishing a game to the public, you should have the logo, link to privacy and terms of service ready here. But for sake of this tutorial, I'm just going to enter the required fields, the app name and the email. Here, in the scopes, you'll need to list out what information you need from the user. For this tutorial, we only need the email. Click Save and Continue for the next two pages. You might notice that the consent page is set to testing. In this state, only the user in the tester list can access the app, which you can edit here. But since we are not getting any sensitive information from the users, we can simply publish the app. If you are getting some sensitive information, you'll need to submit your app for verification before publishing. Great, now we have the consent page published. We can proceed to the next step. On the left panel, click on Credentials. If you are doing this for a desktop game, on the top panel, click Create Credentials, OAuth Client ID, and select Desktop App, and name it whatever you want. Cool, we have the desktop client ID created. Copy this client ID and secret, and paste them into your .env file for the Godot Firebase plugin. Alright, let's go to the Godot editor. We need to add a new button and label it Sign In with Google. Then connect its press signal to the script. In the script, we need to get the auth provider by calling firebase.auth.getGoogleProvider. Then call firebase.auth.getAuthLocalhostProvider and port. The port will be 8060 by default. When the login is successful, the login succeeded signal will be emitted, which will be handled by our previous implementation. Alright, now we are done. It's that simple. Let's try out the implementation. Cool, it worked. Next, I'll show you how to implement this for web builds. First, let's get back to the Google Cloud console. On the credential page, we can see that there's already a web client ID created automatically. Click on it, you'll find the client ID and secret on the right hand side. Copy and paste them to your .env file. This step is very important. If you use the desktop client ID and secret for a web build, it won't work. Next, add the URI where you'll host your game here. Remember to add the localhost too if you are testing your web build locally. Then click Save. Back to the Godot editor, remove this line from the previous implementation for desktop. First, we'll need to set the redirect URI. You can place the URI to where you want to host your game. In my case, I'm testing locally, so it will be localhost with the port 8060 and index.html. Then call firebase.auth.getauth with redirect with the provider as the argument. This will open up a web page to ask the user which Google account they want to choose from. After that, it will redirect back to the link we stated with the authorization token. We want to handle that token when the game starts. Copy the first two lines here and paste them in the ready function. We want them to be re-executed if the automatic login fails. We can get the token by calling firebase.auth.getToken from URL and pass in the provider. If the token is not null, we can try to login with OAuth with the token and provider as the argument. Same as the desktop implementation, its result will be handled by our previous implementation here. Oh, one more thing. There's a bug on the plugin that will prevent your web build from working properly. I've already created a pull request to fix it. The fix might be in the latest build at the time you install the plugin. But if not, you can download the 4.x branch instead. Alternatively, you can follow my workaround here. Go to add-ons, godot.firebase, auth.gd, find the getToken from URL function. The JavaScript feature tag is removed from Godot 4, so it will always return false, which caused the game to skip the following lines. Replacing it with web will fix it. Alright, let's test our implementation. And we're logged in. By the way, I've uploaded this sample project to GitHub. Link is in the description. That's all for this tutorial. If you find it helpful, don't forget to leave a like on the video. And please consider subscribing for more game dev tutorial and contents. I'm Boon, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.